In additive manufacturing, every thermal cycle leaves behind a hidden signature, residual stress. If left unchecked, it can cause warping, cracking, and mechanical failure. But what if you could predict and control it with precision? In this tutorial, I'll show you how to extract and analyze residual stress directly from your thermal model in Abaqus, giving you tools to optimize your 3D printed parts like a pro. Let's get started. Alright, the first thing we should do is to go to the working directory and opening the CAE file. We have the model here. If you remember the last time, we simulated this two-layer additive manufacturing. So if you haven't watched that video, you should watch that video. I put the link on top here and in the description. Okay, so the model 2 is the model we simulated. And this is the job. I'm going to look at the result. And we need to put it on nodal temperature. And as you see, the layer is cooled down to the room temperature while the substrate is already 172 degrees centigrade. So we need to increase the cooling time in order to make sure that it reaches the room temperature. Then we go to the step, and here the last one is 100. I put a very high value such as 2000 and click on OK. We don't need to change anything else and we need to submit the job. It's recommended to have another job, for instance, multi-layer, longer cooling. Okay, we submit the job. If we hit OK, we monitor the job and we wait for the job to be completed. So the job is completed. But before we go to the result, if you're enjoying this video, I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a comment. It's completely free for you, but it really helps me out and keeps me motivated to make more content. Okay, we go to the results. This should be nodal temperature. And this is the final cooling. As you see, it is 25 degrees centigrade. This is what we want. All right, now we can jump back to the part, and here we need to copy the model and we name it residual stress and we click on OK. From now on, every change we make is in this model. And make sure you double click on it. It should be an underline under the model name, so we make sure that we are in the residual stress. First things first, we need to modify the material's properties. So I go to the Inconel, edit. We need to add mechanical elasticity, plasticity, as well as the thermal expansion. Starting with elastic, you should check this one, use temperature dependent data, and I have an Excel file containing all the data. And if you need this Excel file, just let me know in the comments, I can send it to you. I select this one, Control C, and here Control V, we have this one. Now from mechanical plasticity and plastic, we use temperature dependent data, and here Control C, we go to Abaqus, and Control V. Next one is expansion. So you can either use the subroutine, or in this video, because it is simplified, we don't need a subroutine, and we only copy paste this value here. This is okay. Now we go for the layer and we do the same thing, mechanical elasticity and elastic. This should be here. We check the use temperature dependent data. Now it's time to go for the plasticity and plastic. And this one is here. Control C. And it's done. And mechanical expansion, temperature dependent data, the expansion is right over here. OK. Now we are finished with the materials properties. Let's go to the step. Here we need to remove all of these steps. So by holding shift and clicking on the first one and last one, we can delete them because we need to create static general steps. It should be static general, as I mentioned before. The time must be 20,020. This needs to be 10 million, so basically 7 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The initial 1A minus 5. I copy and pasted this one. 1A minus 30. And I put this one on 500. This is the step we wanted. Another thing is to go to the field output and edit. We only need the stresses, so we don't need the displacement. We don't need the force here. We uncheck everything because we don't want to have too many files, so we only need stress. The step is done. Now let's go to the load and boundary condition. So here in the load, when you go to the load, you don't see the previous data here. Then we don't have any boundary conditions here, but we have the predefined field. I'm going to create a new predefined field. So here, predefined field 2, step 1, other, and it must be temperature. And we continue selecting everything. And you click done. But here, instead of direct specification, we need to use from results or output database. So I need to open the directory, and this is what we have: multi-layer longer cooling. If the characters of the path and the file name exceed 80 characters, you're going to have a problem, so you basically need to change that. Alright, begin step is 1 and the end one is 11, and mesh compatibility must be compatible, and we click on OK. So we basically reading the files from the ODB output files from the previous simulations. So we need another thing here, which is boundary conditions. I want to create one boundary condition in the initial step from here. So we can rotate this here, and we select this one. Let's say we have to clamp them. We encast the bottom part totally, or if you have the welding, you can clamp only the corners. And this is also done, and we should go to the mesh, make sure to change the element types. So we click on this one. Done. Now it needs to be standard 3D stress. We go to the substrate, this one, select everything. Done. 3D stress. Everything looks good. Now it's time to create the job. I want to name it residual stress. Remove the space. Continue. Okay. Now let's submit the job. And the job is completed. Okay. Let's take a look at the results. This is the residual stress we have here, and to be fair, it's really high. 796 megapascal is really high, and here we have the highest in the center, which is in the layer. So let's go to the contour option and the maximum and have the show location, and you see this node has the highest Mises stress. Now what matters for us is the S11, which is in the X direction, and S33, which is in the Z direction, also known as transverse and longitudinal stresses. So let's take a look at S11, and this is the maximum location, is somewhere inside the layers, one of the layers, and this is S33, which is right here. Now we want to create a path in the longitudinal direction and one path in the transverse direction to see how it goes. So from tools, we go to the path manager and we create. First we go for longitudinal. Continue. We can have viewport selection, add after, because we want to select them from here. Let's create something from here, here, and here. We carefully want to select it. Now we rotate it here, have them here. This can be okay for the path we want. We click on done and okay. Now create the transverse. Transverse. Now please continue and add after. So let's create it from here. It's completed by going through the end. Now it's okay. And we click on okay. Now it's time to plot those. So from create XY data, we go through the path and we want to see the transverse. Okay, this is the transverse one. And let's plot this. As you see, it looks like the typical residual stress curve. So if we just open two random papers, we can see the same thing here. For instance, this is the residual stress they did have, or I can pop up another one. You see here, this is the typical of residual stresses. And we also can have S11 here. We can apply okay and plot. This is what we have in S11, and we also can have the Mises stress, which looks like this, and we can have the longitudinal one. We plot them. As you see, there's something like this. The shape is not ideal, but if we define the path accurately, we can have a better thing here. So the field output, we can have S11 and plot. This is the S11, as you see here, goes down. What is clear in this scenario is that the curves follow a similar trend. Just keep in mind, this Abacus tutorial is for educational purposes only and doesn't include validation or comparison with the article. And that's it. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, like and subscribe for more Abacus tutorial. Want to master three-point bending? Click on the video on screen before it ends. Stay tuned. See you in the next one.